Hi and welcome to my channel. This is Eleni and today I will show you how you can make this kind of Christmas trinket box out of any packaging box that you have. I am going to use this round cheese box and to cover it up, but also to make it sturdier, I'm going to use white gesso and tissue papers. I am applying the gesso all over it and when the first layer is dry, I go over it with a second layer. While waiting for it to dry, I'm going to use air drying clay and a silicone mold to create a star to put on the top of it. I always like to put a little bit of oil, any kind of oil will do, in the molds, especially the new ones, because I find that it gives a better impression. And the air drying clay I prefer to use is this one called DAS. It's an Italian clay. And I love it because I've never had any problems with it cracking while drying, and also it doesn't shrink too much. You should keep in mind that all these clay projects will shrink while drying, and some clays shrink more than others. Also, don't forget to keep the leftover clay in an airtight container, as you saw me do, so it doesn't dry out. Now we have to leave it to dry, and that can take a few days, depending on the brand of the clay. For me, it took around 4 days. So now you can use tissue paper or paper napkins, as I will do here, to make the box sturdier. Don't forget to separate the layers of the paper napkin before using it. And I'm using Mod Podge to adhere it. You can also use matte medium or some other glue intended for collage techniques. And you can do as many layers as you need to make it as sturdy as you want it. Just keep in mind not to make it too thick where the lid goes, because you have to be able to close it. When you are working with round boxes like this one, it's easier to bend the round edge if you make small cuts around it, as you see me do here. I dab on some white gesso to make the design fade out. And when that layer is dry, I continue with acrylic paints. You can use any color you like. I'm using 2 shades of gold and a copper color around the edges. And you can see the lovely texture that the paper napkin left on the box. I just love that. When all this is dry, I go over it with an acrylic varnish, and I like to use the shiny, or in this case the satin one, but there is also a matte one to use if you prefer that. Here it is totally dry, and if you have trouble closing it, you can use dry soap on the edge like this to help it slide on and off. Here you will see me use black velvet paper to cover the inside of the box, although I forget to cover the bottom of it at this stage, so you will see me do that later on in the video. Now you can use any paper or fabric that you have. And you can also use acrylic paints to paint the inside instead, if you prefer that. Back to our star. I'm using sandpaper to smooth the back of it, and then I will use the same acrylic paints I used for the box to paint it. But this time I start with a darker color, and I will also use a silver color on the raised areas. After that, you will see me use my small embellishments to decorate it, and most of them are nail embellishments that I usually use in these kind of projects. I use glossy accents to adhere them because it dries quickly, but any glue will do. Now the smart thing would be to use the varnish before putting on the embellishments, but I'm always impatient, so I forgot that. So I'm doing it here, trying not to work over the beads, not to dull them. And here I'm putting the velvet paper I forgot on the bottom of the box. I'm also using this silver trim on the lid to match the silver on the star, and later on I will also adhere the star to the box. You can use whatever glue you like, but I prefer hot glue for this because I find it easier and faster. And this is it. My upcycled Christmas trinket boxes are done. Hope you enjoyed my process and got inspired to create your own. Thank you so much for being here. Stay safe and happy holidays!